योगः कर्मसु कौशलम्।
I don't think that I have to tell you that I am Dr. Jagdish Joshi, because you know me now, and I don't have to introduce myself. We have talked a lot about refresher course, online course, importance of it at various junctures. Friends, as I promised you earlier that I'll be with you for the whole course, and I'm keeping my promise. I am with you during the whole course. We are meeting once again. As you know, whenever we meet, I introduce a new resource person. So today also I am introducing a new resource person to you. Today's resource person is Dr. Vikas Raval. He is presently serving as an assistant professor of English and communication skills at Gujarat Power Engineering and Research Institute, Mehsana. He is having more than 10 years of teaching experience. He is recognized PhD guide at Gujarat Technological University, Ahmedabad. He has guided 5 PhD students and 10 MPhil students in the field of English literature and languages. He has been awarded prestigious GTU Pedagogy Innovation Award for his remarkable work in the field of flipped and online learning. He has published more than 30 research papers in national and international journals. His areas of specialization are English language teaching, contemporary literary theories, and applied linguistics. Dr. Vikas Raval is going to talk about how to make the teaching of reading more effective and interesting. I invite Dr. Vikas Raval here on the platform.
Thank you very much, sir, for providing me this chance to be the part of this online initiative. Thank you very much, sir. I, Dr. Vikas Raval, welcome you all in this online module on teaching reading. This module is based on various components of teaching reading in the classroom. First of all, I'll talk about the importance of reading skills. It will be followed by the discussion on various components of the definition of reading. I'll also talk about various purposes of reading and major processes involved in reading. I'll provide some practical tips to make the language classroom interactive through activity-based learning. Finally, I'll talk about some web resources that will help us to create material for our language classroom. First of all, let us explore some major learning objectives of this module. To define reading comprehension, to understand the major purposes of reading, to understand the major components of reading abilities, to explore major researches in the field of reading, to explore innovative ways of teaching reading in the classroom. Now let us talk about importance of reading. As we all know very well that listening, speaking, reading and writing are four major important components of language learning. Out of these four skills, reading and listening are considered as a receptive skills. Unfortunately, even though we know the importance of these skills, we never try to develop them systematically. Reading helps us to expose ourselves to new things. It helps us for self-improvement, it helps us to improve understanding, it helps us for various actions, it helps us to gain experience from other people. Finally, it helps us to boost imagination and creativity. Now it's time to explore major components of effective reading. No single definition of reading is adequate to define it. The dictionary gives the simple idea that it is correlation between what we know and what is written. On the basis of various definitions of reading, I have identified the major components of effective reading. These are the components of effective reading. Reading is known as a rapid process. It is a resourceful process. It is a two-way process. It is also known as planned process. It is a flexible process. It is an evaluative process. It is a meaningful process. It is a comprehending process. It is a process of knowledge creation. And finally, it is a linguistic process. It is not possible to discuss all these components separately in this module, so I'll discuss some major components. Effective reading should happen systematically in any purposeful situation. The systematic reading of the text enhances effective implementation of various processing components of reading. Depending on reading purpose, an effective reader will read almost all text at the normal speed between 200 to 300 words per minute. I quote Bevanzet, "Synchronization of numerous processes involved in reading comprehension is necessary, and certain processes require to be carried out naturally." I unquote. Another component is that reading is a two-way process. First, the various processes involved in reading are executed virtually all together. During the process of identifying words very rapidly and keeping them alive in our working memory, we also analyze the construction of sentences to bring together clause-level meanings. We also build a main idea model of text comprehension in our mind. It can also be said that reading is interactive. It is interactive in the sense that linguistic information from the text corresponds with information stimulated by the reader from the long-term memory as background knowledge. These two knowledge sources, linguistic and background, are necessary to build the reader's understanding of the available text. The reader should be strategic in order to balance many skills needed for reading comprehension. The reader requires recognizing difficulties in the process. A deliberate reader can be defined as a being capable to read flexibly in accordance with changing purposes and the ongoing monitoring comprehension. Similarly, reading is considered to be evaluating process, where the reader needs to decide whether the information being read is logical and resembles the purpose of reading. The evaluation also leads to learner's motivation for reading. Reading is always goal-oriented, that the reader reads through different ways with differing reading goals. These characteristics of reading needs to be clear to anyone working in academic setting, where the most universal way for learners to obtain new information is only through reading. Lastly, reading is fundamentally a linguistic process. Without linguistic exploration, it is difficult to discuss or interpret a text. For example, anyone who has tried to read a text on political policy written in Greek language. Without knowing any Greek characters, it will be very difficult to recognize the meaning of the important message.